We've heard and watched the earthquakes in Syria and Turkey. Many people died. We pray for Allah's mercy on them and their families. This is the time to help and support them as much as we can and to reflect on what happened. How can we support them physically or spiritually? And why does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send tornadoes, hurricanes, and earthquakes to people? Allah is the most merciful, isn't He? Allah is the most kind, isn't He? There are a lot of kids and innocent people around, so why would He send calamities to them? What is the wisdom behind it? Inshallah, we will answer these questions in this video. All praise be to Allah, and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We've heard about the bad news and seen what happened during the earthquake. Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow the earthquake to occur? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered this question in the Quran by saying, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما منعنا أن نرسل بالآيات إلا أن كذب بها الأولون وآتينا ثمود الناقة مبصرة فظلموا بها وما نرسل بالآيات إلا تخويفا. In this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains very clearly that He frightens us so we reflect and repent to Him. Because we forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we forget that this life is temporary. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to be awake and reminded that this life won't last forever. And on the day of judgment, the earth will shake and people will run away from their loved ones. So don't be heedless and don't waste time disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala thinking you won't die. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَى وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى وَلَكِنَّ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the earth would shake trebly on the day of judgment. Nursing mothers would be distracted from their babies, and the pregnant women would abort out of fear. Moreover, people will look intoxicated when they aren't because of the difficulties of that day. That's why these signs and calamities happen. Our fear leads us to repent and draw closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But will we repent? Is this heedlessness going to end? Some people will repent and understand, while others will not. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran. أَوَلَا يَرَوْنَ أَنَّهُمْ يُفْتَنُونَ فِي كُلِّ عَامٍ مَرَّةً أَوْ مَرَّتَيْنِ ثُمَّ لَا يَتُوبُونَ وَلَا هُمْ يَذَّكَّرُونَ. Earthquakes, volcanoes, cyclones, and eclipses are signs that tell us to repent directly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and use our reasoning to understand the purpose of life and the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, قُلْ هُوَ الْقَادِرُ عَلَىٰ أَن يَبْعَثَ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابًا مِّن فَوْقِكُمْ أَوْ مِن تَحْتِ أَرْجُلِكُمْ أَوْ يَلْبِسَكُمْ شِيَعًا وَيَذِيقَ بَعْضَكُمْ بَأْسَ بَعْضٍ انظر كيف نصرف الآيات لعلهم يفقهون. Allah is the most strong and we are weak. We're nothing without Allah's mercy. Yet, why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do this when there are kids and innocent people around? We should understand that life is not the end and it is the place for the test, not the place for the rest. Furthermore, we believe in destiny, whether good or bad. In this way, we could understand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers the question above by saying, وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَن يُقْتَلُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٌ بَلْ أَحْيَاءٌ ولكن لا تشعرون ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses martyrs and tests their families. And on the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them the best rewards. Have you heard about the people of Afia? Who are they? Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, On the day of resurrection, when people who have suffered affliction are given the reward, on the day of judgment, the people who didn't get trial or test will wish that their skins had been cut to pieces with scissors when they were in the world. This is due to the great and unimaginable rewards that people who were in calamities and tests received. They were tested because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them and He wants to elevate their status in Jannah. And when Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was asked, which of the people is tried most severely? He said, the prophets, then those nearest to them, then those nearest to them. So what is our duty to our Muslim brothers and sisters in Syria and Turkey? Alhamdulillah, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you see the believers as regards their being merciful among themselves and showing love among themselves and being kind, resembling one body, so that if any part of the body is not well, then the whole body shares the sleeplessness and fever with it. So Muslims around the world are saddened by what happened, and we all feel the pain of this loss. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Therefore, we should remember them in our prayers. Everyone should do their best to assist them, whether it is in the form of money or any other form of support. May Allah grant them patience and compensate them for the loss of their families and replace their fear with peace and tranquility. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect Syria, Turkey, and all Muslims. O Allah, forgive me, my parents, and the believers when the Day of Judgment will be established. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.